Hey everyone. Happy Fire Freak Friday. I was going to take this perfectly calm moment as an opportunity to review my diary entries because I probably have quite a backlog. But it won't let me access that part of the menu. I also cannot talk to Clef, so I'm going to have to deal with this problem before we can review the progress for the week. Alright. And break. Alright, well, there are multiple enemies, which makes me think that having a weapon that splits into five is probably a good strategy. Oh god. Those things do a lot of damage. Well, that's one of them down. Alright, two more. Gotta get both of them on the screen here. And I don't want to use ooze hit everything on the screen magic. Oh god, it got big. Because I want to save her magic for heals. And I don't think Hikaru's magic would do much. Because this thing's made of fire. I probably should keep more of a distance from this thing. Ah, that fire claw. Brutal. Maybe I should have saved Umi's magic for this form. This seems like more of a threat than the first form, which is usually how boss forms work. Well, this sucks. Ow! Alright, potion. Now's your time to shine. I determined that this doesn't revive people, right? Oh, it does. Oh, it also restores magic. Good. Wait. But the health potion and magic potion are separate. Did I die right before I used it? Is that why it restored her magic? That's weird. Ooh, how could you have defeated my fire monsters? But I can't be concerned about this trivial win of yours. Soon I will silence you once and for all, and Zagat's sweet love will be mine. Will be mine. I've got your number, you sad little puppet of Zagat. It's 867-5309. Nice job, Umi. Oh. There is a child. Oh, you poor dear child. Were you scared? Don't worry. Everything's alright now. Ah, what happened to the real Umi? She certainly seems to have mellowed so far in her journey, and quite unexpectedly. Cutscene? No? Oh. Just a bad guy cutscene.
Seems as if Alcyon has been denied success once more.
She not only departed without your permission, but lost to those three in your name. It is nothing short of a complete disgrace, my lord. I take full responsibility for her escape and her actions. I am prepared to die, Master.
Charming, but unnecessary for now, Inova. Just continue to monitor her activities.
As you wish, my lord.
Well, they seem to have their shit together. Lady, save your kid. Rainbow amulet? Oh, it is. Wasn't expecting that. Hey, no problem. Alright, it's time for some reviewing. First, I'll chat with Clef. I feel sorry for the people of EA. Alcyon did this terrible thing to entrap us. Now that we've mired the good people of the village in this, they must hate us. Oh, Clef, what should we do? I simply feel terrible. The only thing to do is to redouble your efforts to rescue Princess Emerald. It is the only way to ensure that this doesn't happen again. Good advice. Always remember the pain of the people in the burned village. Keep the pain of this injustice within your heart and let it fuel your advance. Alright, write all this down. Inferno at EA. IA. Oh my god. So many entries. Oh, I'm sorry for not keeping up with this, everyone. Okay, red 16. Red 17. Alright. Here we go. See you in a few minutes.
Apparently, Caldina was the one who controlled the village men. She made them work on building the cave. It makes me sick that she has this kind of power. I bet Zaygot is behind it, too. I'll do my best to help the villagers break free from her magic. Ferio headed into the cave to fight Caldina, who was manipulating the villagers. I need to make Ferio look good so he and Fu will make up. Jeez, those two sure make me work hard.
We went into the cave to do battle with Caldina, who was sent here by Zaygot. Now Ferio's behavior makes perfect sense, and I feel like a heel. I have to apologize to him as soon as possible. I just hope it's not too late.
I managed to make Caldina disappear. It seems that Ferio has been following her for some time, since she was acting suspiciously and not dressed for the weather at all. I just hope Fu has had time to patch things up with Ferio. I think they make a cute couple.
Watching Fu and Ferio's relationship is really getting on my nerves. Fu finally patched things up with him, but now Ferio is too shy to tell her how he really feels about her. Talk about lame. I wish they'd just kick this into high gear. We have a job to do here.
Now that Caldina is history, the men in the village seem to be back to normal. That means they can give me all the answers about this place that have been bugging me. I think I'm going to be very busy.
Don't recall them having any answers.
A staffer at the hotel told me that I should visit Rafarga at the outskirts of Rosen. There was a big snowstorm, and the door of his house was frozen fast. I guess it doesn't bother him, though. He just smashes through the thick layer of ice with his body. Man, he's tough.
I've sure met a lot of weirdos since arriving on Sephiro. Add one more to the list. There's a man here named Rafarga that bashes his body into the door to his house because it keeps freezing shut. Is this normal behavior? Maybe for a mental case.
At first, Rafarga was reluctant to teach us his door crashing method, but after we told him why we desperately needed to learn it, he relented. Even though I've now learned it, I'm still not very good. Oh well, Thankfully, I have Hikaru and Umi to pick up the slack.
I finally learned the crashing technique that Rafarga taught us. Just when I thought I'd never master it, I heard Umi scream and forgot myself for a moment. When I lost my fear for that instant, I was distracted and I did it! I can't believe Rafarga was a bodyguard for Princess Emerald.
I know that Hikaru considers all living things our friends, even bugs. Unfortunately, I don't subscribe to the same thinking. In fact, the reason Hikaru finally mastered the crashing technique is because of me! Huh! Imagine that!
When I woke up this morning, Hikaru had mastered the crash technique. Apparently, she stayed up late last night to practice until she could do it. I really admire her dedication. I'll have to ask her how she managed to finally learn it.
After we passed through the underground cave, we ended up in a village on fire. In fact, some of the houses still had children in them. We had to go in and save them.
We are in big trouble. We came out of the underground passage and into a sea of fire. Sephiroth is a mysterious place, but this is much too weird to happen here naturally. I'd bet my shoe collection that Zagat is somehow behind this arson.
Hikaru finally managed to teach Umi and I the crash technique, which allowed us to enter the underground passage. But when we came out the other side, did we get an eyeful? The whole village of Ai was on fire. It was horrid.
Ai. Thank you.
We found out that Alcyone was the one who set the village on fire. Fortunately, we managed to defeat her and save the children in the burning house. I was surprised at how hard Umi fought against Alcyone. Maybe I don't know her as well as I thought.
The evil woman we met when we first came here was the one who set the fire in Ai. Bitch! I was so mad that she put those innocent children in danger. Now those poor villagers have no shelter for their families. Zagat must die.
We managed to defeat Alcyone and rescue the children. But I can't rid myself of the feeling that she set this fire on purpose to lead us to some untimely end. I feel so sad that we may be responsible for the fire that destroyed these poor people's homes.
Look, y'all aren't responsible. Zagat and Alcyone are responsible for the fire. There's not... You can't think of responsibility and morality that way. The person who set the fire is the one responsible for the fire. No, I just wanted to talk to you. Please. No problem. Oh, who's Athena? I bet she's another pretty lady. Yes, to the hospital. Yeah, me too. That sucked. Larry. Oh. I will. I mean, you can just touch the fountain and be instantly completely healed. Or maybe that only works on Magic Knights? But if so, it's a little weird that every town has one. Boy, that was a close one. If you hadn't put out the fire, we'd all be extra crispy right now. By the way, please don't tell anyone that I was screaming like that. My girlfriend would never let me live it down. The entire town was on fire. It's normal to scream. Yeah, it was one of those magic fires. Alright, so if I go south from here, that probably takes me to Larry. Hi. Okay, now's the time to be upset about your house. Now that the fire's out and you're not dead. I'm very sorry for your loss. Well, before I do that, let's see what Club has to say. Oh, same stuff. Okay. Well, I have enough rainbow amulets to maybe potentially unlock something, so let's head back to the Rainbow Elder and see what he has to say. I probably can't get anything good, since I only have one of each, but worth checking. No, not... I don't know why I did that. Like, this doesn't look like a place. I don't think I pressed the button. Does it automatically enter if you just stand there for a second? That's strange. Alright, friend. What can I get for one of everything? So I think the only thing I can afford is the picture. God, I wish I could get this. I mean, not that I've had to do that much walking. Magic points slowly increase as you stand still. Alright, this better not actually consume my rainbow amulets. Like, if it's impossible to get everything in one playthrough, that would suck. In fact, I'm going to save my state, just in case. Because if this actually consumes them, I don't want to waste them. I don't think it's cool that you're selling this, dude. Like, it's not cool that you have it, and it's definitely not cool that you're selling it. I don't think it's actually, like, revealing or anything. But it's still a picture that she doesn't want people to see. Someone took a photo of her eating an apple. And it surprised her. Okay, so that doesn't actually consume your amulets. That's good to know. So I would like... I didn't want to talk to you. I would like this a lot. I don't know what this is. Oh no, that lets you recover magic points. I don't know what this is. And these, I think, just make a noise when you're walking around. Which, sure. Alright, well that was an exciting conclusion to that build-up. I must have pressed the button accidentally. Yeah, that was weird. Okay. Well, head to Larry. Take me to the hospital. Sort of banging my head against the controller. Against the microphone, I mean. Yep, I'm here to visit the hospital. Here it is. Me too. Wow. That is a real messed up ideology. But, like, imagine that that might be the case. This is some kind of strange looking lamppost. Well, it's a checkpoint, but if I had 50 rings, I could jump into a portal to a special stage. Fruits basket. Woozoozoo! Sure. Give me the moon fortune. See, now I need to actually buy a potion to replace the one that I used, because I actually used it. Helping others in distress is a way to show kindness. You got that out of a fortune cookie. Come on. Okay, lady. Thanks for shouting at me. Question mark behind the plaque. Oh. I thought that was some sort of plant. Yeah, right? No, I just think she should stop shouting. Like, magic doesn't work better when you're louder. Of course. Whoa. Let's clip through that kid's reality. How careless. It's a nightstand. That's where you put books when you're done reading them before you fall asleep. What? Like, I know these characters came from Earth. They're familiar with how people act. But... Alright. Yeah, sure. Someone has a book next to their bed. It must be a sex book. Big chest. At least they didn't turn that into a crass joke. Oh no. They've lost their mojo? They need to get their groove back? It's a wardrobe. Like, I appreciate how much there is to inspect and hear them talk about. I just wish it was a little better. I don't know. Like, I know it's hard to think of stuff for every little thing, but... like, it took him 3 years to localize us. You would think those 3 years would result in... something better? I don't know. I mean, I like it. I'm not disparaging the game as a whole. It's just... I wish that part was better. Alright, that was 3. This is 2. Here comes 1. Shortcut to the Tree of Life. What, through here? Was there another staircase up? But you could have them say, oh, this reminds me of my wardrobe back at home. I wish I had X article of clothing that I kept in that wardrobe. You know, you can make a little riff about how they've been wearing the same clothes for at least days by this point, right? I don't know. You could have them comment on, like, the type of wood that it's made out of. Like, oh, this is made out of a wood that we don't have back on Earth or something. You could comment on, like, the craftsmanship of the hinges or, you know, say, oh, this is put together with different kinds of screws or something. I don't know. Like, this is just off the dome. I'm sure if I sat down, I could come up with some better stuff. A beautiful lady. Uh-oh. Yeah, there's a fountain here, so this must be a danger zone. Well, maybe I should talk to everyone before I proceed to the Tree of Life. Figure out why people have lost their mojo, or at least get an inkling about it. Alright, so this is where that kid was studying. Studying to be a doctor, I assume. Hey, character portrait. Oh, today's race. I wonder if he'll be teaching us some sort of dash ability. Cool hair. I'm here to get that magic jewel, and if I have time, visit the hospital. Okay. Well, I'm guessing that there must be another exit from the hospital that leads there. Athena, I've heard great things. The signs say don't run. The one on the left. Please take a number. Oh, I've got your number. Oh, I like the recurring theme of numbering things with pips. That's a nice little touch. Magic that we normally use to cure sickness and disease has suddenly stopped working. All I can do now is take it day by day and hope for a miracle of some kind. Ooh, what about your healing magic? Can that do anything? My healing wind is for healing injuries, not curing disease. I suppose I could try, though. No, that kind of magic won't work. If only we had a leaf from the tree. Tree? What tree is this? There's a huge tree that exists behind the village, called the Tree of Life. The leaves from the tree contain a magical sap that is said to cure any disease. The problem is that getting leaves is nearly impossible. There are monsters everywhere. So wait a minute, if we were able to get some leaves, these people could be cured? Yes, and that's just what we're going to do. But don't you understand how dangerous that could be? Would you rather see all of these helpless people die? I didn't think so. That settles it. Let's go. Aww. Futuristic IV unit. There's Tree of Life juice in there. I mean, surely some people are hospitalized with injuries, right? It's not all infectious disease. Abner? That must be character portrait, man. Aww. He seems like a good dude. Thought I might be able to inspect that book. Yeah, you do that. Aww. Alright. Well, that will do it for this week. Thanks everyone so much for... Wait. Foiled again by scripted events. Hi there, girls. You're new around here, right? The name's Abner. Wanna go somewhere and get acquainted better? Even in Sephiroth, you get hopeless dorks trying to pick you up. Yuck. Look at them go. Yeah, those kids run every day to stay in shape. Fast, aren't they? That's nothing. I'm as fast as a cheetah. What the heck does cheating have to do with this, bird legs? Hey, unless you want to feel my foot where the sun don't shine, don't stare at my legs. Alright, relax. Sheesh. If you're so confident, why don't you race with us, babe? I'll race with you. Hikaru, cut it out. We don't have time to waste on stuff like this. Haha. Afraid of losing? Bird legs? They're just kids. There's no way I'd lose. And stop calling me bird legs! Don't bet on it, Chicky. I've been training these kids personally. Besides, you expect me to believe that a cute girl like you can beat these hyper children? That's enough. Save your small talk, Romeo. I'll show you. Alrighty then. But there's a catch. If you lose, you have to go out on a date with me. Like that's a possibility. I don't have control here. This is still part of the cutscene. Ah, she used up all of her energy. Hey, no fair. It's a marathon, not a sprint. Ha 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 ha. They blew you away because I taught them my instant dash technique. Yeah, great. Really great. So when do I get my date? Date? I never agreed to that. Yeah, good. What drops in the dialogue box. Okay, that'll do it for this week of Magic Knight Rayearth. I'm over here, Umi. We have to say goodbye to the audience. Thanks everyone for watching. I had a tremendous time. I hope you did too. And I hope you have a good weekend. I will see you on Monday. Until next time.